Very good afternoon, everyone. Good afternoon, everyone. Today, we are starting with the next chapter or the next concern with respect to the foreign exchange markets and rates. Going with the overview of this particular chapter, yesterday, on the first lecture, we have seen with what a foreign exchange is and what is the meaning of foreign exchange. So, foreign exchange market is a place where the currencies are traded. So, different types of currencies we have into existence or persistence, and when we exchange the currencies of different countries, then we call it as an exchange. And the platform or the market in which these particular foreign exchange or for currencies have been exchanged or changed, that particular market is called as a foreign exchange market. Then we have seen different types of currencies, different origination and modes of currency that are into existence. So different types of currencies or the major currencies that are traded in the world are with respect to the currencies of different countries of US dollar, European Union, Japanese yen, UK pound and Australian dollar. Then furthermore, we have seen with the introduction of Indian rupee with respect to the development of symbol, development of usage of currency in terms of its sign and denomination. Then we have also dealt with the various types of currencies that are into existence with respect to their payment terms and conditions and the convertibility factor or the convertibility perspectives. Furthermore, after the concern of the major currencies establishment, what we have seen, how the particular currency gets converted or denominated at every point, at every location, and what is the value of this particular currency as on today. So here, this particular figure identifies and states you what is the amount of currency that has been traded daily. So that being on a daily basis, currency market is open 24/7, and it is always a particular person or a particular, it is always of a particular concern that it is always available for a particular person whenever it has been required at any point of time. So day in and day out, at any point of time, if you need this particular type of currency, it is made available. So in terms of a 24/7 market, it is always available at across the globe, and the rates keeps on changing. For example, if you need a dollar currency, if you need a euro currency, yen currency, pound currency at any point of time with different availability of locations at different between the market situations also at the international airports also, or with the help of certain traders and the certain stockists, your currency can be made available and you can exchange the certain currency that is required for you or desired for you. If you need a certain currency of either going outside India, that is if you are traveling somewhere else, then also this particular currency can be made available. Or if you are coming to India, then also the foreign investors are made available with the Indian rupee currency. So accordingly, the government has to look for the proposition, request a necessary arrangement has to be made, and the currency procurement can be provided accordingly. So with respect to the availability of 24/7 market, the market gives you a certain picture as to how the currency is made available and in which country or which locations, which country can be sourced out and can be made available accordingly. So according to the demand and supply, according to the need of the customers, according to the need of the people, the currencies is provided and with respect to the specific time zone. So the changes of the price, changes of the currency value, it also keeps on changing with respect to the time zones also. So at different time zones location with respect to New York, London, Frankfurt, India, Tokyo and Sydney, the time zone keeps on changing and the market has been circulating or rotating. The major currencies that have been traded in the world is with respect to US dollar, the euro, the British pound, the Japanese yen, the Swiss franc and the China yuan. So in this way, these are the major various currencies that are traded in globe accordingly. The first thing, the United States of America, wherein they are having their foreign official national currency as US dollar. The US dollar is by far the most widely traded currency in the globe, despite its decline and shakiness in the recent past. So it is always seen that since 1950 or 1980s onwards, there is a frequent changes or fluctuations in the dollar prices or the dollar currency valuation, but still it is termed or denominated as a dominating currency because it is also widely used as a vehicle currency in foreign exchange transactions. So most of the international transactions, most of the business transactions of international trade and commerce are in dollar denomination only. For example, now just take an example, we have a look. A trader wants to shift funds from the Indian rupee to Egyptian pound with the with first sell INR for USD and then sell the USD for EGP. Even though there are two transactions instead of one, this is one most preferred method of exchange as the USD or Egyptian pound market is more active and liquid than the INR or EGP. So if you want to consider a particular transaction, now I'll explain it in simple terms. There is a particular trader and he wants to purchase Egyptian pound from Indian rupees. Now, Indian rupees is available with him and he wants to purchase the Egyptian pound. So in order to purchase the Egyptian pound, what he has to do, he cannot, or he is not having a certain physical position as to purchase of Egyptian pound. So first he will transact of purchasing the Indian rupee or converting the Indian rupee to US dollar. So this will be the first transaction wherein he will be getting US dollar. After getting the US dollar will be exchanged in terms of Egyptian pound. So here two transactions are into existence. INR, that is Indian national rupee, to USD, and USD to EGP, that is Egyptian pound, into existence. So here what we see, the major currency that has been traded into use or major currency that has been to picture is of Egyptian pound only, and other countries or other currencies trade are not being traded very effectively and at a very faster rate. So in this way, at every point of time, there is a certain dollar denomination. There is use of a dollar currency at a very faster rate, and it keeps on circulating at every frequent position. Other major currencies in the world trade or the global trade includes various types of currencies with respect to the euro, the Japanese yen, the British pound, and the Swiss franc. So in this way, different types of currencies keeps on trading and it keeps on acquiring by the different organizations. So as per the need, as per the demand, as per the supply in the market, the currencies have been traded across the globe and it has been supplied accordingly. The first concern is with respect to the euro. The euro is the official currency of the 16th of the 27 member states of the European Union, the second most traded currency in the world after USD, that is dollar. The euro has a strong international presence like the US dollar and has emerged as one of the most premier currencies after US dollar. So it is always treated as the second most traded currencies in world. So after US dollar, the euro is the second most traded currency and it has been adopted by 16 of the major 27 nations of the European Union. So 27 member countries, they have adopted this currency as the official currency of European Union. Second currency that we are dealing with or taking into consideration is the Japanese yen. The Japanese yen is the third most traded currency in the world. Now, why it is called as the third most traded currency? Because the world yen stands for the round object in Japanese. So yen is in very liquid around the world and has a much smaller international presence in the international dollar and euro market. So in comparison to dollar and euro market, it has having a smaller present international presence, but it, the meaning of yen is a particular concern of a liquidity or a round object. So it keeps on circulating, it keeps on rotating round the clock. So the availability of this particular currency is available 24/7 and it keeps on circulating. So it is the third most traded currency in the world or the international market. The next perspective is of the British pound. Until the World War II, the pound was the currency for the reference. The official name of the currency was of pound sterling. So until the World War II, it was known as pound sterling. But after World War II, this particular currency was just only, after the World War II, now it is only called as the British pound. So it is another most traded currencies in world. The next currency that we are seeing is the Swiss franc. This Swiss franc is the only currency of a major European country that belongs neither to the European monetary or to the G7 countries. From a foreign exchange point of view, the Swiss franc closely resembles the pattern of the euro but lacks its liquidity. Now, whenever I say it lacks liquidity, it specifically means that the availability of this currency is very minimum level. So there is a particular shortage of this particular currency, and in terms of liquidity also, it is not available at very frequent stage. So we need to understand and can come to a certain conclusion with the understanding that the Swiss franc currency is also most traded currency, most preferred desired currency after the euro currency. So if a particular option is not available for you with the euro currency, then you can switch to the Swiss franc, and the Swiss franc currency can be adopted for your international trade or international transactions. In this way, we have seen the major traded currencies of the world with respect to the euro, the Japanese yen, the British pound, the Swiss franc, and the first currency that has been traded is the major currency, the dominating currency is with respect to the dollar currency of US, that is United States. Now, the three reasons for foreign exchange. So what are the major reasons or what are the various certain aspects to due to which the foreign exchange is into certain demand, that is the demand and supply, the exchange of foreign exchange, the exchange of these particular currencies is into a notch, is into a much higher position. The first thing is in terms of tourism. So in terms of tourism, what happens? People migrate from one place to another place. People transfer from one place to another place. They go for traveling purpose. And whenever they are traveling from one place to another place, in order to purchase something, in order to roam around at certain places, in order to spend a certain sum of money, in order to tour a particular currency, you need a certain sum of valuation in their respective home denomination or home domestic currency. For this particular concern, in order to the when the tourism industry started to develop day by day gradually, then the demand for the currency also increases. For example, if you as a particular Indian person, if you are going outside India, at for example Europe, that is Germany or France, or you are going for US, then you must be in need of euro currency or pound currency or in US dollar currency. So with these way, what happened? The tourism factors is into existence. Or in reverse situation, if the foreign nationals or foreign tourists are coming to India, then they will be exchanging their dollar currency with respect to the INR, that is Indian national rupee. So tourism is the major reason or the first reason due to which there is an exchange of foreign currency at a very higher scale or a greater scale. Second perspective is with respect to the international trade. Majorly what happens whenever the international trade transactions is into picture or into considered, what happens? There is a certain person perspective with respect to the exchange of amount or a certain value of money. Now, whenever this particular value of money comes into picture, the export and import of goods and services is always for a certain value consideration. Now, this particular value consideration cannot be in a specific currency or a domestic currency. For this particular concern, what happens? A certain member nation or a certain trading nation can impose you a certain rules or guidelines with respect to trading the currency into their own currency. So with the impact of their international trade, the dollar currency is mostly widely preferred because it is a most available currency, most preferred currency, and traded as an international global currency. So due to this concern, what happened? Due to the increase in the international trade, international transactions of import and export, there is a certain need of foreign exchange and the currency has been traded at a very higher or a larger scale. And third thing is the major reason is of international investing. So in order to invest at the international level, you need to have a certain sum of money with you. And this particular money should be in denomination of the Western currency or the foreign currency itself. So whenever you want to invest a certain sum of money in certain another country, then at that particular point of time, you must have that particular hold or the reserves of this particular currency which you want to deal with. So for your international investments purpose also, the availability of currency should be made available with the respective investor, and then only he can further invest that particular sum of money or that particular amount whichever he is intending to. So here in this way, we have seen the three major reasons of foreign exchange transactions. It is with respect to the tourism, the international trade, and with respect to the international investing. Now let's look further with the factors affecting the foreign exchange rate. So the various factors that affect the foreign exchange rates are, the first thing is differential in the inflation and interest rates. So it has been observed and seen that there is a certain frequency or changes in the inflation and the interest rates of the foreign exchange currency. So due to the increase or decrease in the inflation rates, the rates of currency also keeps on changing. Due to the change in the interest rates of the respective banks, there is a fluctuations in the prices of the respective currencies. Next thing, it is with respect to the current account deficit. With respect to the your balance of payments account, what happens? A particular country, a particular nation has to hold a certain sum of currency at a particular point of time with the International Monetary Fund or the World Bank as a part of reserve. Now, whenever a certain currency is maximum traded, what happens? The circulation of currency is at a certain position wherein the availability of this particular currency determines or denotes what is the position of your currency into the world market or international market. So your current account deficit is a certain position which directly affects or impacts your foreign exchange rate or your valuation of currency in international market or the global market. Next thing is it with respect to the public debt. Now, public debt is a particular concern wherein the people of your country, the people of the home country or the domestic currency, are, if it is they are of a debt-ridden nature, what happens? They are trying to hold a certain sum of money for a very larger scale, wherein if your spending pattern, if your expenditure pattern is not increased at a higher level, then at this particular point of time, there is no liquidity into our economy. Now, if there is no liquidity into the economy, the debt, public debt, starts increasing day by day, and it affects or impacts your foreign exchange rate. So your currency keeps on fluctuating and floating. terms of the trade, depending on the terms of the trade of the transaction. That is, if a particular member nation imposes a certain condition as to conducting a transaction in terms of a specific currency, then with respect to the trade terms also, you have to undergo that particular transaction, and accordingly the transaction needs to be conducted in the specific terms or the denominations only. The terms of the trade, your international trade transactions can be of a certain principal position, wherein a particular country, for example, if you're trading with US, the US may impose a certain terms with respect to the denomination of currency or the payment terms in respect of dollar currency only. If you are entering into a transaction with China, China may impose a certain condition with respect to payment of terms and conditions in respect to yuan only. Japan may impose a certain taxes or a certain amount or a certain condition with respect to payment of terms and conditions in terms of Japanese yuan also. Or in this way, several countries may impose you a certain terms of trade and you have to follow accordingly. So due to this concern, what happened? Whenever you're trading this particular sum of money at the respective certain region or a certain level, this particular point of time is a certain stage wherein your foreign factors, it affects directly, and your rates in the international market, your foreign currency transaction keeps on fluctuating accordingly, and your rate of currency of the domestic currency is also fluctuating. Next point is with respect to the political stability and economic performance. So your political stability into the economy, into the country, also directly impacts your foreign exchange rates or the valuation of currency. So with the change in the government, with the change in the government policies, stressed on rules, regulation, norm that are into existence, your transaction value, your trade values, your currency value keeps on changing. So based on the economic performance with respect to the balance of payment situation, it keeps on changing, it keeps on fluctuating again and again. Now, going further with respect to the how the foreign exchange market works. In the retail currency exchange market, a different buying rate and selling rate will be quoted by the money dealer. So what happened? There are different dealers available at this particular point of time, and whenever they quote different rates, the rates for the different currency have been quoted by different dealers. So whenever the individual dealer, the different dealers are quoting different rates, the average of all these particular rates, the summation of all these particular rates has been found, and accordingly the rate of a currency has been decided. Most trades are to and fro from the local currency. So depend on the most of the traded transaction, it has been observed that most of the traded transactions are with respect to the home currency or the domestic currency, that is the local currency itself. So if a particular trader is in India, then his most of the trading transactions will be in terms of Indian INR, that is Indian national rupee. If a particular investor or trader is from US, his most of the trading currency will be in respect of dollar currency only. The buying rate is the rate at which the money dealers will buy foreign currency, and the selling rate is the rate at which they will sell the currency. So if a trader, if he is selling a certain sum of currency or a certain value of currency for a certain rate, then that particular rate will be called as a selling rate. And if a buyer is quoting a certain price for purchasing this particular currency or XYZ currency, then that particular currency rate will be called as a buying rate. The quoted rates will incorporate an allowance for a dealer's margin or profit in trading, or else the margin may be required in form of a commission or in some other way. So at this point of time, whenever this particular transaction or activity takes place, what happened? You have to take into consideration with respect to the commission or brokerage or the margin for a particular dealer. Now, a particular dealer or a mediator who is available at this particular point of time, what happened? He may take a certain position wherein he wants to recover his own margin of profit. So in order to recover his own margin of profit, he may charge a certain sum of additional amount. So that particular additional amount may be recovered in form of a commission, or it may be recovered in form of some another way wherein he can set off his respective commission and the amount can be settled down accordingly. Now here, this is the way in which a particular currency's rates have been decided. So for buying and selling, you have a certain different rate. So buying, in the sense, the first column, that is the left-hand side column, denotes the buying rate, and the right-hand side column denotes the selling rate. So a particular display picture of a dealer is been specified here, wherein he is displaying his rates of US dollar. So if you, as a particular trader, if you approach him, he will buy your dollar currency for 29.75, and if you want to purchase, that is, if he wants to sell the dollar currency, then he will sell it at 30.55. So always that particular margin of 30.55 to 29.75 is a certain margin wherein he needs to make is available for himself. So in this way, the margin has been set for an individual dealer. Second example with the GBP, that is Great Britain pound, you can see if a particular dealer wants to purchase GBP, then he will purchase that particular GBP for 47.85. And if he wants to sell this particular GBP, then he will sell that particular GBP for 49.27. Whereas from your perspective, if you are selling GBP, then you will sell this particular GBP at 47.85. And if you want to purchase GBP, that is Great Britain pound, then you will purchase this GBP at 49.27. Always remember, the rates of your particular trader is always in a reverse position to a particular purchaser. So the rate of 29.75 for buying of US dollar for a trader is the rate of your selling for of 29.75 for a particular seller. In this way, the rates are in a reverse situation. So now the further picture with respect to the different rates may also be quoted for different kinds of exchanges and for different types of cash or the amount of currency that you are dealing for. So a particular currency may have also different values, different currency denomination, and different rates for different currencies. So at every point of time, at every level, the rates are different, the valuation is different. For cash transactions, that is exchange of currency, it has been different. For the for documentary form, that is for a traveler check, the valuation may be different. Or for electronic transfer, that is for the credit card purchase, or if you are doing NEFT or RTGS, the rates of the currency may be different. So at every point, every stage, the rate of currency for every transaction keeps on changing with respect to different currency denomination. Next perspective, you can see there is a generally a higher exchange rate on documentary transaction, such as for traveler check, due to the additional time and cost of clearing the document, while cash is available for release immediately. So or resale immediately. So at this point of time, what you can see, a point of time where the transaction amount, the valuation of amount, or the time that has been required is at a very latter stage. In this particular case stage, or in this particular case, the amount of currency, the rate of currency can be a bit higher. So here at this point of time, we can understand that whenever a particular transaction requires more time, and this at this particular point of time, the rate of currency is bit higher. Whereas in case of a paper currency transaction, wherein you can exchange the currency at a very frequent position, that is within a fraction of seconds and very immediate basis, at this point of time, the rate of currency transaction is quite low. So it differs from what type of or a mode of or nature of transaction that you want to deal with. Now, coming with the perspectives or understanding the perception of finding an equilibrium for an exchange rate. So in order to find an equilibrium in an exchange rate, there are two methods that has been proposed. So the two methods that have been proposed for understanding the equilibrium rate is as follows. The two methods for for the currency transactions are, the first thing is the balance of payments method, and second thing is the asset market model. Now let's look at the individual perspectives of individual equilibrium model in detail. The first thing, now the going with the first perspective of purchasing power parity approach. Now purchasing power parity approach is a way of determining the value of product after using or after adjusting the price difference among the exchange rates. So PPB model, that is purchasing power parity model, it is clearly determining the value of a currency after adjusting the price difference. So if the particular currency has been traded for buying at 47.89 and it has been sold at 49.85, so whatever the difference of either 1 rupee or 1.5 rupee is made available, that particular value determines what is your purchasing power parity, that is your PPP. Indeed, it does not make a sense to say that a book cost of $20 in US dollar and euro 15 in England. So the comparison not equivalent. So you cannot say that the currency is having a certain denomination, that if a particular book is costing $20 in euro or $20 in US, the same book may cost at 15 euros in Europe. So it does not find a certain comparison. But in terms of your currency transaction, there is a certain feasible position or a certain value with respect to your denomination. If you know the exchange rate very well, and if you can compare or convert your currency respectively in respective terms and conditions and transactions, then you can actually book your currency and you can convert this particular currency in whatever denomination that you need or it has been required. So if a goods can be freely traded across borders with no transportation cost, the law of one price position that the exchange rate will adjust until the value of goods are same in both the countries. So at this particular point of time, what you need to understand, you need to take into consideration that whatever may be the transaction, whatever may be the value of your goods and services, you need to understand what is the value of your transaction, what is the value of currency in the international market or in the global market. Now, at this point of time, the major composition is with the concern of the transportation cost. There is complete absence of the transportation cost because there is no actual movement of currency that is into existence. So here what we can see, the currency is not actually moving from one place to another place. It is just changing its mode. Whenever if you are doing an NEFT or RTGS or you are transferring the money with your electronic mode, then at this particular point of time, the money does not change in an actual position. Only the value keeps on converting or the value keeps on changing as per the need and requirement of the respective vendor. Of course, not all the products can be traded international. Example services, there are transportation costs, so the law does not apply it as a whole. So at this point of time, the PPP model is not applicable for services wherein if actual rendering or delivery of services it is been required, what happened? The PPP model fails at this particular point of time. Why? Because there are certain transactions wherein you need to physically go and you need to provide or render those services. Now, when these particular services are needed to be rendered, what happened? At this point of time, the services are not into actual position, and this says a certain situation wherein the goods and services needed to be traded accordingly. So the availability of currency, the availability of goods and services, the valuation of the currency at the international market, the financial positions of the respective country, the balance of payment, the credit current account deficit, the availability of goods and services, the availability of stock, the fluctuations in the international market, the local or the domestic market position, each and every factor component needs to be taken into consideration, and then only the purchasing power of a currency can be identified. The purchasing power parity model clearly gives you an understanding or an information about your price differences and the exchange rates of different currencies at different level. So a currency that is having a certain value of 75 rupees per dollar at India, it may be different in Sri Lanka, it may be different in Japan, it may be different in China, it may be different in Singapore, and so on. So a single currency may have different values, different connotations, and different supportive interpretations at different level accordingly. Now, going with the next model, that is the balance of payments model. The balance of payment model holds that a foreign exchange rates are at an equilibrium level if they produce a stable current account balance. So based on your stable current account balance, your foreign exchange rates have been decided, and it is always look for a certain position that it is maintained at an equilibrium level. So maintaining an equilibrium level is always needed to be ascertained and found out, wherein you have to find out the rate of transaction, and accordingly the foreign exchange rates have been decided. Now, how this particular rate of equilibrium can be decided? The rate of equilibrium can be decided depending on the prices that have been quoted by different buyers and sellers. So always a buyer quotes a certain price and a seller quotes a certain price. And if this particular price matches with the respective buyers and sellers, then a proper transaction gets settled, and accordingly the transaction or the currency is been exchanged. Now, the stable current account balance is of a certain concern. Now, this particular currency concern with respect to the stable current account mentions you clearly that if your current account balance is of a stable nature, then it is been assumed that the country is having a proper reserves of this particular currency, and whatever may be the situation, the company can pay its debt, the country can pay its debt towards the any situation which is into existence or which may arise in a near future. A nation with a trade deficit will experience a reduction in its foreign exchange reserves, which ultimately lowers or depreciates the value of its currency. So depending on the availability of resources, depending on the availability of currency into the world market or the domestic or the international market, the currency, the nation has to decide about in what position they are, whether it is a trade deficit or whether it is a trade surplus, whether it's a currency prices are at a reducing rate or at an increasing rate, and what is the situation of their foreign exchange reserves with the country. So depending on your foreign exchange reserves of a particular country, what happens? You need to identify in what position you are ultimately looking at. So whether your ultimately currency is being lowered or whether it is being higher, whether the valuation of the currency it is being depreciated or the currency is getting appreciated. Now, considering all these factors with respect to your trade deficit or trade surplus, reduction or increase in the share prices, foreign exchange reserves or surpluses that is made available, the increase or ultimately lower or increase in the prices, the depreciation or appreciation in the value of your currency has been decided, and accordingly, the position has been set off with respect to the terms and conditions of the availability of buying and selling. If a currency is undervalued, its nation exports becomes more affordable in the global market, while making imports more becomes expensive. So depending on the valuation of currency, if the currency is overvalued or undervalued or at a stable stage, your export becomes either affordable or costlier. So in terms of your global market, what happens if your currency keeps on undervaluing? What happens? Your import becomes increasing or costlier and your export becomes cheaper. So at this point of time, now if your currency is overvalued, that is your valuation of currency starts increasing, then at this point of time, your import becomes cheaper and your export becomes costlier. It is a reverse situation, but it depends on your availability of currency, holding of currency, and posing of a position of your currency into the world market or the global market or the international market. So based on the availability of currency, based on the fluctuations, based on the prices, and based on the current account and capital account deficit, your amount of currency, your valuation of currency, it's directly proportional. After intermediate period, the imports will be forced down and the exports will rise, thus stabilize the trade balance and bringing down the currency towards equilibrium. Now, how this particular equilibrium can be achieved? Now, after a point of certain point of time, whenever certain period passes, what happened? The imports will be forced down to increase or reduce at a certain level. So at a certain point of time, whenever there is a certain situation wherein either the imports are increasing or either the exports are decreasing, if there is a certain situation wherein your currency is either overvalued or undervalued, after a certain position, it will be at a certain position wherein it will be stabilized situation. Now, this particular stabilized situation will be in a certain position wherein the goods and services will be imported and exported at a certain feasible rate. The goods and services that are made available will be of a proper denomination, proper position. The transactions will be settled within a proper time duration, within the proper time requirement what has been made, and thus it will stabilize the trade balance. Now, this particular trade balance with respect to your trade deficit or trade surplus, it will be balanced automatically and it will bring your currency towards the equilibrium position, wherein every country that is having its own currency, every currency that has been traded into the world market or the foreign exchange market, it will have a same par value and the value will not change at very frequent level. Another perspective is with respect to the asset market model. Now, going with the second perspective of the asset market model, the balance of payment model focuses largely on the tangible goods and services, whereas it ignores the increasing role of the global capital flows. So, based on the balance of payment model, what we need to see, we need to take into consideration and identify what is the availability of goods and services that are into existence. So, balance of payment understands or deals with the tangible and intangible goods and services and the currency transactions of a particular country. What is the amount of currency that has been traded? What is the amount of currency which is available in terms of reserves of with a particular nation and the valuation of currency at the global level or international level? So, if you are trying to ignore the increasing role of the global capital flows, what happened? Your balance of payment model may also fluctuate at that very point of time. So, in order to maintain the proper fluctuations model, what we need to see, the assets are being valued at a proper level. All the tangible assets are at a certain position that the value keeps on appreciating and it is always having a stable value in the international market or the global market. In other words, or in simple terms, money is not only chasing goods and services, but to a larger extent, financial assets are always chasing, are also simultaneously chasing the stocks and bonds. So there is a direct relationship between the valuation of a goods and services with respect to the financial position of the stocks and the bonds. So the stock market, the bond market, the equity market, the debt market, the bond market, everything at this particular point of time is interlinked, and based on your availability of reserves, based on the availability of the goods and services, your market position, your balanced position, your equity position, your debt position has been determined, and accordingly the valuation of currency has been decided. Next perspective is with respect to the flow from transactions involving the financial assets go into the capital account of the balance of payment and thus balancing the deficit in the current account. The increase in the capital flows has given rise to the asset market model. Now, asset market model, how does it come into picture? It comes into the picture with respect to the movement of transactions, movement of your financial assets in balance of payment. So, your balance of payment movement with respect to the current account deficit. So, deficit or surplus in the current account gives you a certain rise that your financial assets either increases or your financial assets either decreases. With respect to your capital account transactions, your capital account transactions are always either at a surplus level or a deficit level. It has a certain increase in the value, or the value of these particular goods and services keeps on decreasing. So, with respect to the balancing position of the deficit or surplus in the current account, this has given a certain rise that your capital flow may either increase or your capital flow may decrease. Now, if at a certain point of time, your capital flow keeps on increasing again and again, and there is a certain position wherein you have a certain position of your proper reserves and optimum reserves of a certain foreign currency, then this gives rise to a certain situation of an asset market model, wherein you have a certain position in a certain market, wherein you are trading with a large number of currencies into the market, and the asset market model comes into picture or into position. Next facility here you can see is with respect to the certain share of a stock. So this is a certain denomination, a certain position, wherein you can see the key difference between the balance of payment and asset market model is that the former includes the financial assets, whereas a stock includes its respective calculation. So it is a certain denotation or deposition with respect to the availability of trades and finances with respect to each and every component of the financial asset or the stock that is into holding or into a picture. This, the particular image that you can see, it is an example of a certain document that you are holding in terms of an asset, whether it is a stock or whether it is a calculation. So in what denomination a particular asset can be held, and in how valuation a currency can be identified and can be quoted accordingly. So share of the stock, the key difference, it always clarifies and maintains a certain position with respect to the balance of payment. It will always show a certain position wherein it is having either a surplus position or it is having a deficit position. So maintaining a proper balance between the surplus and deficit with respect to your current account and capital account will give rise or will give lead to a certain position wherein your financial assets will be matched and controlled properly, and the balance between the stocks and the assets can be made at a certain equal level or an optimum level. Concluding statements. Now, with respect to the asset market model views, currencies are as an important element in finding the equilibrium exchange rate. So at every point of time, with respect to the financial markets or the asset market model also, what we need to see, we need to always take into consideration that the proper equilibrium is been provided for the exchange rate transactions at every point of time. So the currencies, it must have a certain view that it should find a certain element wherein after a certain feasible point of time, after a certain stage, the value of the currency must be stabilized at every position, at every level. Asset prices are influenced mostly by people's willingness to hold the existing currencies of assets, which in turn depends on their expectations for the future worth of the assets. So in this particular concern, we can understand and take into consideration that the existing quantities of assets, so whatever the asset that you are holding, depending on the valuation of this particular asset, what you are expecting, whether the value of the asset will increase or whether the value of asset will decrease. Based on this particular fact, you have to decide what is the future worth of your assets, whether the value of the asset will increase. So what will be the value of assets 2 years later, 3 years later, 5 years later, and so on. So accordingly, based on your certain projections, based on your certain willingness, based on your surplus and deficit matchings, you can find out the worth of the assets at a certain future date. The asset market model of exchange rate determination states that the exchange rate between two currencies represent the price that just balances the relative supplies of the demand for and assets denominated in those currencies. So in whatever currencies that you are denominating your respective assets, it directly impacts the valuation of that particular asset. Now, for example, if you are holding a particular machinery, and whenever this particular machinery was being purchased, the purchasing price of the machinery was, for example, $50. Now, when the pricing of this particular machinery is $50, the valuation should be made in terms of the dollar currency, or if you're trading in Indian market, the valuation should be provided in rupee currency. So this is a particular situation wherein you have to be very specific while valuing or while making a value of your respective assets also. Key in which terms your assets will be valued, in what terms your asset will be realized, and in what ways your assets can be noted down in your respective balance sheet. So at the end of the current year or at the end of the fiscal year, what will be the value of assets that can be ascertained or that can be determined, whether it will be in terms of a currency of dollar currency, or it will be in terms of a euro currency, yen currency, or in your home domestic currency, that is in terms of rupee currency. And lastly, these assets are not limited to consumables such as groceries or cars. They include investments such as shares of stock that is denominated in the currency and debt denominated in that currency. So in this way, what we can see, the assets are not only limited to the consumables, that is your groceries or cars. So it is not only related to your durable and non-durable goods, but it is also applicable to all types of goods and services. So the currency valuation, the asset valuation of these particular goods and services, it is applicable for all types of transactions and all types of assets. So whether it may be a fixed asset, fluctuating asset, floating assets, current assets, non-current assets. All type of assets can be valued at an equal level, at a given position, and you can find out the valuation of these goods and services at every point of time. So the asset market model clearly identifies and clearly states you about what is the various modes or ways in which the particular valuation of these particular assets can be done, and you can identify the exchange rate between the two currencies. So understanding and ascertaining the different exchange rate of currencies, it gives you a certain rise or certain position wherein you can identify, you can claim, and you can observe a certain fluctuations in your respective currency prices. So the balance of payment is also directly impacting and affecting your valuation of currency with respect to the PPP model, that is purchasing power parity model, with respect to your asset market model, with respect to your balance of payment model. So with respect to the different asset market model, balance of payment market, whatever is available, your equilibrium exchange rate can be decided, and you can bring a certain currency at a certain feasible position. So a proper balance between all the value, all the currency transaction needs to be ascertained, need to be maintained, and accordingly the price of currency can be set for the international market or the global market or for the world market. In this way, today we have seen with the different types of asset market model that is into existence, the market model which are going or regulating in the world market or in the international, dealt with in detail, wherein how different trade currencies, how different transactions determines what will be your prices of goods and services, what will be your amount of valuation of goods and services at a respective point of time, and how it needs to be ascended at each and every individual level. So ascertaining the value and prices of goods and services is